my friend. I'm pretty well good myself. Man, that neck. Ugh, I heard that. Oh! There we go. I had to get it in myself.
From too much PC gaming.
That'll do it. It's a tough life. No, it's not. I mean, first world problems. Alright. So to see who goes first, we have a die we can roll.
And we just... okay.
Ta-da!
I wonder who the winner is.
Take the flame.
Yeah, sure.
Flashback turn. Whoa.
This hand is okay.
Did I?
Did you shuffle?
I might not have shuffled enough. It might have been in deck tech order, which is fine. I'm going to try it regardless. This is going to go. No, I shouldn't. Let me see. Oh, it was still in deck tech order. I didn't shuffle it nearly enough. I remember why, because I made some changes to the list. That's right. And put it back in order there. Well, that's fine. I'll take 6.5. 6 and a scry.
Combat.
It was 5 lands, Cabal Therapy, Dread Return. Wait a minute. And the lands were 3 were the same, then 2 were the same. That doesn't happen too often in this deck.
12. 15.
Doesn't happen often at all. Alright, mein Freund.
You
do. Good luck.
Oh,
wow. Cat. On deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six. Okay.
Seis.
I have to keep.
Okay.
Yep. Okay, you do
that. So do you scry after you decide if you want to keep or not? Or
exactly, yeah.
That's right.
You don't use it as part of your decision. Alright, so Cephalid Colosseum, Lion's Eye Diamond.
Oh, that's a good start.
Eight.
Yeah, I think so.
Got a reader.
Are you blocking this one or these?
Oh.
Actually get it started a little bit earlier.
Yeah.
We're going to go breakthrough, x equals 0. So I'll draw 4 cards and then discard all but x cards in my hand. Well, x is 0, so I'll draw 4.
And discard 1, your all hand?
Yep, and discard the whole hand.
Your guys will exile him because...
So,
no force.
Stinkweed, Golgari Thug, Dread Return, Careful Study, Gemstone, Flare, Lion's Eye Diamond, Breakthrough.
Okay.
And then,
poor Aaron.
Pass turn.
I'm gonna put that in my Trump Cat deck now.
Fuck
yeah, that advanced Felidar. That feels so good. I don't know. I'm looking it up.
Yeah, so that'll date this video just a little bit, but they did in fact ban Felidar Guardian. I'm surprised it wasn't in the original announcement. I'm not sure why it wasn't.
Well, that's what they said. They said their data showed that the win rate went up.
That's what I'm saying. I don't think
Chase, that deck got better. I think would you happen to know why they didn't include that in the original announcement?
That's what we're talking about. What it is they, on Magic Online, for the first time, they pre-released the set on Magic Online.
Yeah.
And they were going to kind of use that as a buffer to decide. They wanted to give it a couple weeks to see what Amaket would do to the combo. They thought it would balance it out.
It got worse.
Well, the win-loss ratio shot up to over 50%.
Like 48%.
Yeah, it shot to 48% win ratio.
They said the number of 4-1 losses, or 4-1s and 5-0s on Magic Online went up significantly.
Gonna shuffle.
Right. See, what I'm thinking is, I don't think...
Yeah, when you take a combo deck, and you give it all these cyclers to find its pieces, somehow I imagine that's right.
Well, yeah, well, they released the set on Magic Online. And the reason they didn't ban it initially is because they were like, we're gonna wait so we think there's cards at Amaket that will help balance... the field and make the deck weaker.
Yeah.
I think they're
wrong. Cycling just generally makes combo that much stronger.
And the deck got better.
Okay, I'm gonna go outside. You're all
oh yeah, you said
everything.
Thank you.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When you come back in, it'll look like...
I always set mine on the side away from the camera. not Thug. Stinkweed out.
I put mine left side. Always.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay.
Is this a good position?
That works. I do mine like this because I have a bunch of cards. Okie dokie, so this is my hand. Well, not much I can do right now, so I think we pass.
Okay. Play a vault. Full vault.
Mm-hmm.
You only have one card in hand, correct?
That is correct. Graveyard, field, other rest of field, hand.
Black, blue, Baleful Strix.
Resolve, draw a card.
Yeah. They're playing cards like cast out, that new
Pass.
Flash right. Enchantment that cycles.
We're going to miss Ichorid. We're going to dredge four. One, two, three, four. I see Faithless Looting.
Just pure strength. That's probably why Mardu was falling back on.
All right. We're going to pop the Lion's Eye Diamond, discard my hand, make red. So, Black Lotus.
Mm-hmm.
You know where this is going. We're going to flashback Faithless Looting. We will start off with Stinkweed Imp, Dredge 5. I'm going to set this over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, there's a Narcomoeba, but where are the thugs? Where are the thugs?
I don't know.
And then, next dredge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we finally have
a
bridge.
You got a bridge, okay.
We finally have a Grave Troll.
You know what's going to be big with the exert?
Okay, and then because of the way that it's worded, I have to discard those.
Think about exert, give everything double strike, or give everything trample, or just...
I'm trying to think.
Yeah. Always watching, you put the guy in there that taps everything and gives you another combat.
Now is probably not the time, I suppose. So we will pass the turn, my friend.
Okay.
It's like, okay, board wipe this.
I don't know what Gunner was up to.
Beat you to death with this
Underground Sea.
Look at my cadet.
I'm so glad. Infinite combat, no! No!
Man. I think he doesn't like it.
He has vigilance. You can exert him. Untap everything
Connor.
Else.
Results?
He doesn't tap in the first place.
Yeah.
Exert him again. Exert him again.
Infinite combat with one indestructible trampler.
Okay. Leave him.
Or
mm-hmm.
one
Draw.
Flyer.
I mean, the catch is he only has
Play
one
death,
toughness,
right?
So... Theoretically, well, if they have a 1-1,
we're getting there.
There's so much stuff that just makes us okay, you can't block. Okay, yeah. Like, you just knock down the blockers, basically, or they can't block.
Main phase?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Great. But I don't think that's going to be as strong of a combo as the Helio.
Who are you guys playing, Lazy?
Yeah.
Do it like that. One, two. Pass.
Let me eat now.
All right, buddy.
But hey.
Air troll.
Yeah, it's kind of bittersweet for me, though. I just built
Where's
a deck
stuff?
That I think can contend with a combo.
Gone.
So I don't even get
like,
I don't even get the satisfaction of curb stomping it.
Yes.
I knew that they weren't going to...
Alright, so you know how this works, right?
No, it's...
Ichorid, I have to exile a black creature from my grave.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Alright. It's upkeep, so...
It's called...
You wanna play something?
I know dredge mains never forget that. I'm not a dredge main, so...
No, it's not the song.
I'm saying main, as if we're playing Smash Bros. Or something. Alright, so we'll dredge six. One, two, three... 4, 5, 6. Okay. Well,
we're about to get started. You're not supposed to be back yet.
Let's see, my friend.
Like
still only one bridge from blow, which is definitely not.
So whenever a creature enters your graveyard, you get a zombie token.
And whenever a creature I control dies.
Oh, okay.
I get a Zamboni.
Zamboni.
Zamboni token.
Is it a 2/2?
Oh.
Yes, they're 2/2s.
This card's really good.
Hmm.
But whenever a creature... Is it whenever... When do you have to sack it? Whenever a creature enters my graveyard?
Whenever a creature, yeah, enters your graveyard, I have to sacrifice it. That's correct.
Alright, I like Stasis here,
so... There are a number of ways I can play this, and I think I'm going to try the hyper-cautious way, which is...
True, but that also deals with any non-land permanent.
Oh, that's true! That is true. The six are only creatures.
Alright.
Okay, now I see the value. Okay.
My friend, I would like to go to combat.
Sure.
I'm going to swing 7 at you. This one flies, these two are on the ground.
This will block the Narcomoeba.
Okay, so we'll trade. Our triggers for Bridge from Below will go on the stack. I'll stack them with my triggers resolving first. So I will get a zombie, and then Bridge from Below will get exiled. Okay, so there we go. Now that we've gotten that,
usually they ban cards when they.
And I'll go to.
I just realized all of my. If I don't have a playmat, yes. All of my cards are black. So we're going to have to come up with some other way to represent it, and I know just the way.
All those guys on Magic Online that are like, okay.
Magic cards.
All these cards to build this deck.
Why not?
That works.
Alright, so now that that's out of the way.
A standard card, if you have bought the card within 3 weeks, refund the money on Magic Online.
We will.
Some of those cards are expensive on Magic Online.
Sacrifice both Ichorids,
like,
and
if you
I guess
them, do it.
Actually, we'll start off with sacrifice Ichorid for Cabal Therapy, targeting you, naming Force of Will.
You're casting Cabal Therapy?
Yeah, I'm casting Cabal Therapy for its flashback cost of sacrifice a creature. I know I'm not supposed to name what it is until it resolves, but... Oops.
Yeah, that's right. Let's see what I want to do.
Alright.
Might have a response.
I know you brainstormed already.
I can't kill your creatures.
Jumped the gun on that a little bit.
Fuck it.
Force, pitching, spell pierce. Okay. That'll do it. And I will sacrifice these three for Dread Return, targeting Flare of the Hatebound.
You're going to cast that?
Yeah, so I'll reanimate it for 0 mana. Banned in Modern. Days, I'll pay 1. Take one. By the way, I needed to have taken one earlier from Breakthrough.
Alright, that's good.
Flare will kill the Deathrite Shaman with its Enter the Battlefield trigger.
It's only been, it hasn't been on the, it still has Summoning Sickness, right?
Yes, you can't use it yet because Summoning Sickness.
Okay.
It is, it's an Enter the Battlefield trigger, but it requires it entering from the graveyard. So,
what does he even do?
So, it'll, when it or a creature I control...
Does damage equal to its power target creature
yeah,
player.
Yeah,
it has undying, too.
So, if it dies, its undying will trigger and cause it to deal 5. So,
damn.
Pass turn.
Okay. Draw. Play in Volcanic.
Mm-hmm.
Help those guys.
And then, after Monday, they're like, ooh, we're safe.
Yeah.
Damn. I'm missing green. Just realized.
Oops, no Leovold.
Brainstorm?
Yep, results.
Because nobody will know really what to do after that. Vehicle's going to take over. You're going to see a resurgence of red-white aggro.
You control. Brainstormed earlier, so
thing,
I figured you locked yourself.
Maybe, like, a mid, like, Gideon Tribal will be a thing for a short while, definitely.
I don't see that deck being great,
yet. Not standard for sure.
The people will definitely try to...
I thought about making a Gideon Legacy deck.
Double black.
Hi,
Tombstalker.
Tombstalker.
You're a card. You are indeed.
Pass the turn.
Untap. Upkeep.
Same.
Sorry. Okay. We will... Dredge 5. We're going to hit the Stinkweed Imp here.
Okay.
So, Bridge, Gemstone, Bridge, oh my god, Lotus Petal, Lion's Eye Diamond.
You got two Bridges now.
That's great. I do. I do.
They will remove your.
Hi ho, hi ho.
Oh, yeah. I think there's like five different gigas that we're all involved in. Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
But yeah, they'll remove your Gideon.
Got three cards
around. Then all your stuff goes off and you die.
I would like to go to combat.
Sure.
I'll swing for four.
Well, no.
Player blocks.
Okay.
They're good?
That's great.
That's good.
How are you
going to
win?
Player will die, then it will come back with its undying trigger.
Sure.
Five damage to.
That's why
number one. Let's see. Oh, and by the way, and I get, I'm getting some zombies here.
Wait,
I'm getting two zombies.
I guess you don't have to draw.
Oh, okay.
Let me just do this so I don't have the chance to forget. Man, I'll grab a drink when I. Get done with this interaction. So if I hit the tombstalker, I kill it.
And your bridge from blaze gets exiled.
Then my bridge is exiled. Yeah, exactly.
Or you could just hit me to for five. Super Boros Charm me.
Super de duper Boros Charm. Yeah, I think I'm just going to shoot you for five here.
Okay, I'm going to
need a control package deck or a bridge deck.
And then
that's just hard to do with aggro. Unless Mardu just says fucking runs him as a one of.
It's a very technical term he just brought up there.
What?
Unless Mardu just says.
Yep.
I'm thinking.
Pass turn, my friend.
Even like the mangle or any of those other case changes can't do that. So it's all legal.
Yeah. I'm locked on green mana right now.
I believe you.
If you pat that,
attack me, I dare you. Or, as Fox McCloud would say, come out!
It has just like a 3-mana 4/4 instruction.
I like it. I like the Gideon.
Even if you ignore like the.
Oh, what you gotta do, you gotta play the grass.
I guess, that's the only thing I can play. Cast Collagons come out. That good? Resolve?
What modes?
Is it resolve?
Well, you have to declare the modes first.
Do you?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, has to resolve first, and then you choose the modes.
You choose the modes, and then you... So, if it's a decision that's made on resolution, you wait till it resolves, but if it's modes or targets, those have to come first.
Alright, I'm going to shoot one of your zombies. I guess, does that even do anything? You just get two more, right? Is it non-token?
Well, it's only non-token, so I'll actually just lose the zombie.
Yeah, I'll shoot one of your tokens and get my Baleful Strix back to me.
Fair enough.
Okay, and, Let me read this. Pass.
All right. Upkeep. Let's see. There's a putrid imp and a stinkweed imp. I'd really like to be able to dredge, though. So we're just going to bring one back on the back of this Ichorid here.
Mm-hmm.
And then we will dredge five.
Okay.
Right. Oh my goodness. One.
Oh my god.
Two.
What is that?
Three, four, five. Not looking good for you, my friend.
No.
All right.
I'm going to read this.
I can tell you that.
Ugh.
Yeah, it's mean. I know it. Well, we're actually probably just going to end it here, even without the Flamekin Zealot. So we're going to... we are definitely going to end this here. Cabal Therapy Flashback, targeting me.
Okay.
Well, it doesn't matter. I can target you. It doesn't... I can do it however I want. So I'll target you, name, Forza Will. Okay, there's Brainstorm. And then get a zombie, sacrifice these three. Wait a minute, how many creatures are in my yard? One, two. Not you. Well, actually, you do count yourself. You do count yourself, that's right. Three, four, five, six. Enough. Six.
You have six in your graveyard.
Okay, so not quite enough, actually. That's interesting. Oh, okay. So if I do this, so the correct play, I would have lethal here if I had played this correctly. The correct play is Cabal Therapy, target myself, name Stinkweed Imp, drop two more creatures in the yard, and then reanimate Golgari Grave Troll, Flayer of the Hatebound trigger, finishes you. But I didn't do that correctly. So, given that I didn't do that correctly, if I get the Flamekin, it's still not enough. Because Flamekin will be 3, this will be 6, and you have a blocker.
A big boy.
Big old boy. Well, wait a minute. So currently it's 2 zombies and an Ichorid. If I sacrifice these 3, I'll get...
Dredge return back.
2 zombies and a Flamekin's out. Okay, so we're still in business. So I'll sacrifice these 3.
Dredge return.
Dredge return.
Flashback.
Flashback. To get Flamekin Zealot, which, there we go. So, I will give my creatures +1/+1 in haste.
Okay.
Yeah.
Man down.
Yeah.
Where are you from?
And then you take 9.
Take 9?
Yeah.
All right, I'll take 9 and die.
Ruh-roh, Raggy.
Dredge, man.
Man, yeah. I'm learning. Once you get to really know the deck, it does not treat you poorly. Dredge, on the other hand, can always bite you. But as you just saw, it can take someone like even me.
I was playing Dredge, those kids like Artifact.
I'll be okay. Even me.
Game 1, he went off turn before I killed him. Okay, fair enough.
Wow.
Game 2, I'm on
this hand's okay.
I'm
on the play, I assume.
I only got 1
green
exhaustion
field,
just a
duel. Yeah. Uh-huh.
So, okay.
I mean, that's just kind of given.
Okay.
I got a turn 1 good card.
This is fun. I will keep it. Turn 1 spell bomb.
The open card, which is the ghost card.
Okay.
Turn 1 spell bomb, let's go.
And then play a red source, confederate 7, swing through, get victory almost perfectly. I could get... Is it like 16? I could get 17.
Cephalic Coliseum.
Yeah.
Sure.
Take 1.
Okay.
Let's not forget it this time.
So
careful study.
Okay.
Draw 2, discard 2.
Dredge stream.
Is that okay?
Random card.
Yeah.
Mountain.
That's fine.
Aww. Yeah, that's mine. I was like, oh, shit. So like, I can only drop another.
He's
like
a very open
life.
Guy.
Pass turn, okay. All right. Crack 2 Lotus Bloom. Pretend to proceed to sit here for 10 minutes while I go off and kill you.
Yeah. Let's roll, man. What does that get?
3. Lotus Petal.
Bam. 4. I'll be on 5.
Bam.
And you know what that does?
Yep.
I don't know what you're...
Bam.
How many basics do you run?
Bam.
How many basics do you run? Bam.
That is
the answer.
I run plenty of a bam number. A big bam number.
Faithless Looting?
Really, because it was actually
sure.
An awesome little anecdote.
Oh! Mother!
Yes.
Well, I already drew 1. A little too late to take that back, so we'll turn the second one. Not the kind of thing you forget when you actually play the deck full time. So for the second one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you know, I'm going to be optimistic and say that with the Nile Spell Bomb out, it might not be the end of the world that I missed that. Maybe. No, it was bad, but I'm trying to help myself sleep at night. Oh, and I have to discard 2.
You have too many cards in your hand?
Just Faithless Looting says so. Pass turn. Brainstorm results.
Oh, why, deck? Why do you do this to me? God. Fine.
It's also your trigger.
No land, though. Pass.
Jeez. Alright. Now, intentionally, I'm going to miss my dredge.
Okay. Go to your draw step there.
My draw step. Take 1.
Sure.
No,
careful study.
Okay.
Yeah.
2 blood crypts.
I didn't
want to
restock
up
because I don't know what your mana base is. Like.
2 blood crypts, 3
stocks. Oh, I pulled it over.
1.
Is there another black source I can fetch?
That's why I added the second blood crypts.
This is problematic. I can't cast anything. Who are you going to cast? A blood guest?
Yeah,
I was
going to
play another blood guest.
That's awkward.
Very awkward.
Really, you won't want to get that
Well, that's the case, I'm
and then I'll pass turn. I am digging for a specific card is the reason why. I'm trying not to fill my graveyard up too much before I have the ability to deal with that. So otherwise I'll just get blown out.
That's right.
So I'm gonna,
or I may not have much of a choice.
Pass turn.
That's a pretty good start. Turn three.
Pretty much now or never.
That's a hard to get. You guys have all these turns.
All right. Draw?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dredge goes out tonight.
Well, you know two dredgers and then the blood gas I couldn't miss.
You got to do seal them on Friday. And then Saturday. Super fun stuff on Saturday.
Draw
things
Saturday. Which will be gone.
Draw?
If I didn't have the kids, I would be there with you.
This is where
it's just a little long for me to leave them.
Now what do I do?
At home, you know.
Swing for a fuck gun?
I mean, like.
That's a very technical term.
You swing for a fuck gun. All
right.
Well, there, he'll say it for me.
It's not.
But right now, you're.
So how much I like to swing for?
Is it an open?
Mm. Is that what kids are calling it these days?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes, Mom. Yes, it is.
I will.
Did you take the legacy tutorial?
All right. Pop the pedal. Take one. Faithless Looting Flashback.
Okay.
Yeah.
No Dredge?
No Dredge.
Accidentally mill over cards I want to get back. How many shocks do you run?
One.
3 second Padres.
Not
six Padres. So
not
Padres. Shocks.
Let's say three Stomping Grounds, so there's one. Two. Alright, so there should be one more fish.
This game is basically over at this point.
Okay.
For you or for me?
I'm like, I can't.
Yeah. For me.
Because the spell bomb.
Yeah.
And death right.
We'll pop the diamond for red.
Mm-hmm.
Flashback faithlessly.
Yeah, but I'm,
sure.
What I'm scared of is accidentally milling over all my fetchable.
I mean, really
no, I'm just going to pick it up.
Okay.
I'm just going to. Tell me you were the next card.
That's what I had.
You said there's two?
Very nice.
I brainstormed into two more brainstorms. So, I think
jeez.
I was set for that game with a death right too. I could just I had extra mana.
So that's what I was looking for. There's one near the bottom.
There you go.
And the other one was thank you. The other one was okay,
well,
not too far.
Turn one spell bomb in opening hand. That works.
Yeah, no, no kidding. That was a thing. Yeah, when you're looking for those sideboard answers, dig. Just keep digging. Aha. Uh-huh. Say that again just in case the camera didn't get that.
Did you say rug burn?
I had that.
Yep.
I'm playing my rug burn deck in modern.
Get a rug burn.
That sounds kind of gross.
You know, if treasure crews were around, that could be a thing. But thank goodness treasure crews isn't around.
Yeah.
Treasure crews is broken.
So I will be on the play.
Will you?
Oh yes.
Speaking of.
Keep.
Okay, I will decidedly keep this hand.
Okay, we will start off with
a card.
Cephalid Coliseum. Careful study.
Okay.
That's true. This is the first time, so I guess
I'll okay, this is a thing, I guess. Golgari Thug, Flayer of the Haven.
I just want to see what
I want to go off with explosives, but I don't have color.
Pedal?
Discarded these two at the one tap.
Pass.
Back one of these.
Yeah.
Let's get it started.
Badlands?
Oh, the one non-blue dual land in the deck.
Death right.
Hi, Death right.
What's good, Death right?
You're a bad boy.
Pass. Z turn.
Dredge 4. Gotta hurry. One, two, three, four. More thugs. I think I only have two thugs in this deck, and they've been showing up left, right, and sideways.
Well, does it say you may? No, it says put target creature.
Yeah, you don't have a choice. You have to.
Yeah.
So it's in my hand.
It can target itself, right?
What? Oh, no, because it, when it's put into the graveyard, yeah, it can target itself. That's right. Alright. So, pop the petal. Two counters on the gemstone mine. Abrupt decay your death rate, shaman.
Sad.
Sad day, indeed.
Couldn't daze even if I wanted to.
Pass turn. And also the extra.
Hey, son. Where'd you find that?
Thought Caesar? Why would I want to do that in Dredge, you ask? Why not? Against Dredge. Just to see what you got.
Golgari Thug, Cabal Therapy, Abrupt Decay.
Decay.
I was about to say, there is a right answer here.
Okay, so can't get that back.
That's,
go ahead.
That's right.
I already took the two.
Alright. So, again, we'll Dredge four. One, two, three.
I thought that was a correct
four.
Play.
I think you're right.
The
actually.
Wasteland play that turn. Is that a
oh, the
play?
Wasteland was definitely right.
Couldn't play anything else.
There you go.
Or maybe I could.
Maybe, maybe.
Yeah. I'm going to cast the Fatal Saving, and then I'm going
to... Let's see, one bridge.
Fatal Saving, it's still
right? Yeah. You got a Narc Amoeba.
I do have a Narc Amoeba.
It's a good card.
It's a Narc. Narc Amoeba, I'm going to flash... I cannot flash it back.
Can't flash back Cabal Therapy? You don't have black, do you?
I don't have one in my yard, and I can't play it for my hand because I don't have black. So that definitely worked. Definitely worked out for you. Medio. Pass turn.
Crack. Crack cocaine. I mean...
Trop, I'm assuming. Tropical.
Yeah, Tropical.
Like six cards in my hand.
Oh, right.
Alright,
well,
go ahead.
Drop.
Drop it. Bow, 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 bow. Bow, 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 bow.
And after that, I will pass the turn.
No dredgers. Take a draw.
Take a draw.
Swing one in the air. Like I just don't care.
I believe I'll take one damage.
Blip.
Blip blip.
Did I did play the, I did tap the Colosseum earlier for careful study.
You did.
Jay,
you
can't forget that. Can't forget that. Apparently I can. Pass turn.
Oh, you're right, I didn't even draw. You've seen one.
My god.
The top deck. Pass the turn, sir.
The top decks are real.
Yeah, I want to return this
to you. Okay.
Didn't work out.
You're in business.
Something like that.
You can cast something, I believe.
So, we will tap it for black, Cabal Therapy, targeting me.
Okay. That's fine.
Stinkweed Imp.
That's right. Like two,
wonder how likely that was to happen.
I don't know. Who knows what's in your own hand? I can. I don't. Who knows?
All right, go ahead.
And don't come back.
You're in the grave. What are you doing there, buddy?
You were just chilling.
You're way down here, actually. What on earth? Whatever. I somehow made a separate graveyard
for the stuff that doesn't matter in your graveyard.
I guess.
But in Legacy, technically, you do have to order them.
Because
it does matter for certain cards.
Nether Shadow.
Cabal Therapy, sacrificing Narc Amoeba. Get a zombie.
Okay.
Targeting me. Naming. It results.
Thug.
Yeah, name Thug.
They're supposed to be bossies.
Alright, so he's gonna enter the grave and then you're gonna bounce two creatures back to him.
Oh, from play. When he enters the graveyard, from play.
Is it only from play?
Only from play.
Okay.
Okay.
That's the thing. So now you got a 2/2.
Yeah. Probably should have swung in the air first, actually. A little mistake. I'm distracted and tired. That's all. Pass turn.
This is where it just sucks. No, I got nothing. Dredge is
like, yeah, yeah. Sure. I'll put that in
the area. Oh, yeah. All my stuff, I want my hand to discard this junk in my hand.
Yeah, you're saying how Dredge usually
does. Now look at all the shit that I would love to have in my graveyard. Right.
Blue?
Now.
Why am I even playing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Brainstorm.
Okay.
I do, but I don't want to play until I have a blood gas.
That is an aggressive death threat activation. You must really need the mana then.
Yeah, I only have two lands.
Well, usually you can hold it up in case I start to do some shenanigans.
Yeah, I could, but I really need like to be able to cast things first. Let's put one right there.
There's
some
like I said, like
that.
It's not a deck that you just know.
I can see your Baleful Strikes in hand. Sorry. When you were putting them back, you turned your hand and I could see. Sorry.
Boom.
Does a.
But I've got to dredge this, get my lands back, refill my hand to a specific number, swing for a specific number, and then conflagrate, discarding a certain number of cards, deal exactly the amount of damage.
I mean, I guess I'll cast it now anyway.
Sure.
And then I just dredge my mountain and it made me lose.
Draw.
When am I going to draw?
Alright, and then I discard two.
Pass.
Alright. Dredge five.
Okay. I drew a blood cast.
One, two, three, four,
yeah,
five.
See,
well, this could have gone better.
No, I can dredge back
a little bit.
Line, cast the live well on
a good bit.
Make a land drop, mm-hmm. and hopefully get lucky with some graveyards.
Do you not run the Life from the Loam in there?
I need another Life from the Loam.
No, no. A regular dredge does not run Life from the Loam.
Why is that, though?
Why is that?
You don't run many lands?
Yeah, not many lands.
Because you're playing those bigger cards, but yours go so fucking wide, and your stuff comes back. Like, once you get it set,
like,
he's just going to pollute the audio behind me the whole time.
Alright. So we're going to kind of make you cry over here.
Don't make me cry.
Ripping pepperoni. I'm thinking just to make sure there's not something I'm missing here.
Because I trade with either one of these.
I feel like there might be.
Yeah, walk here.
We'll swing two at you.
Two damage at me?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Take five. Why am I 13? I should be
13. Three. Yeah, man, I block.
Alright.
Get to exile your bridge from
below.
That's
it.
Nine damage? Should be 11.
That is fine with me.
What?
Pass turn.
For my doll stuff.
Me.
Just one.
Draw.
I'm the game.
Three. How many of these cards do you
just get aggressive here. We're gonna exile for blue.
I like it.
True name, naming you.
Yep.
And it costs mana.
Okay.
Pass.
Every other recursion is basically free in the deck. No. Because that literally is just a replacement for Scourge.
Okay, here comes six.
Mm-hmm.
One,
I have
two,
this junk in my
three,
hand that I don't want in my
four,
hand, and that gets it
five,
whereas
six.
These cards would, but they're in my yard, and I can't
that's why
cast it.
Yeah, that was definitely an aggressive attack there. I should not have done that.
You got a bridge from below and a.
Alright, so I'm gonna cast Life from the Loam. Get back.
What on earth? Is that the ringtone?
Of course.
You pick up one now, Margaret.
You get three dice, right?
Oh, you're right, you're right.
And why are you grabbing the
your dad's hand? Just left work, so.
Does it really matter what I grab?
Okay. Pass turn.
Really, but you don't want to get the dredge land because.
Well, the only other things I have are fetches, and I don't want to put fetches in my hand because there's nothing to fucking fetch for.
50.
There's Copperline Gorgeous, isn't there?
Yeah, but they're just going to come into play taps like the dredge land.
That's fine, you're not using that.
That's
the reason I say
it
is because you want to miss a situation
okay.
where you don't have a dredger or an ability to cast life form. So.
I guess I have a dredger for liquid.
Yep.
I know, I just don't want the fetches.
Do it for again.
So I just got these fetches.
Boom.
Yeah.
Make my. And drop for the turn. Something else I
want to
do before that?
Dude, Link's taking like almost an hour on the stage.
Here he
hi, Tombstalker.
Let me make sure I want to know what I'm delving for. Two.
I want to trade these two.
Four.
Wait, can I do something with this trigger on the stack?
Because it doesn't really matter, does it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess keeping your creatures in makes sense. Yeah, no snap caster, but keeping creatures in to bluff Kolodon's command.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a ridiculous board against me.
That doesn't give me anything.
Get a combo.
Take three.
Pass. Yeah, true name Namus is Tombstalker and Deathrite Shaman. That's pretty.
No, okay, but
pretty gross, man.
I mean, you need to be
as
possible, so if you end up one of Brianna's,
then
that will
stain
things.
Ichorid. Drop the thug.
Okay.
Stinkweed Imp. Dredge 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Another bridge.
Okay.
That's great.
Okay.
Two more bridges. My bad.
So if I had not made that misplay earlier...
Well, you don't have any black mana, so that's good for me. Can't flashback Cabal Therapy and get 3 2-2s.
This added my black mana.
What do you mean I can't flashback Cabal Therapy? Why can't I?
They don't have black mana.
What's the flashback cost?
It's
sacrifice
a creature.
Okay, I thought
it
was... Alright.
No, I thought you had to pay the cost too.
I always thought it was like tap for colorless
it's all good.
Or remove a counter tap for.
No, sadly it's. Otherwise,
okay.
You played over fast, over pain lines, like always.
So, on that note, Ichorid, sacrifice it to Cabal Therapy.
Sure.
Targeting.
Got a lot of fucking land.
Next one.
Those feed your consecrate. Life alone, back to your hand. Life alone, back to your hand. Consecrate.
Okay, so the obvious one is if I target you, I can name Force of Will, for obvious reasons. I can also name Spell Pierce, Daze doesn't matter. If I target myself, then I can put a Grave Troll in my yard. I'm about to make three into Flayer, four. Do I have another Cabal Therapy in the yard? I do not. So I can't do that. I can't pull that little trick.
I'm going to do it that way just because of what's in the
All right. I think I have to target myself and just hope that you don't have it. So, on that note, targeting myself resolves. Golgari Grave Troll. Three zombies. Sacrifice three zombies for Flayer of the Hatebound off of Dread Return. Flashback.
So you're going to cast Dread Return?
Yep.
You almost
Force of Will.
Alright, I'm going to drag back one.
Yep.
That's probably... Oh, pitching the days. Pitching the days. I was about to tap for it.
Turn it sideways.
Yeah.
Force pitching days.
That'll do it. You stay in the yard, buddy.
Go to 14.
So the alternative was... And this is what I obviously did. Grave Troll, so that I could dredge six and hope to come up with enough to kill you with the Flayer on the next turn.
You probably should have targeted me instead of Force, and then I probably would have forced that.
Land cards hit the graveyard from life.
Yeah. You didn't have that many cards in hand, so I didn't think the odds of Force
You didn't think I had Force plus blue card? I made sure to keep that in my hand.
I took a risk. I thought if I named Force, I still might not have won, because I might not have gotten what I needed.
I did brainstorm earlier, though, so never know.
Hmm.
I could have any kind of cards in my hand.
Alright.
My go?
Afraid so.
Untap. Draw.
I'm surprised you didn't sack the tappage.
I'm going to go ahead and fetch. Get a 13. Get an underground.
Oh, by the way, you are in the graveyard.
It's better than blocking, because I would rather have this in my graveyard.
Is that what
you're
blocking?
I mean, I'm going to
fetch. Here it comes.
I don't know what decision you're
going to
do. Jitay.
Hiya. All right.
Tap those two.
Oh, my God. This is gross.
Quip it to Tombstalker.
Why not?
Go to combat.
Take eight.
Yep. Get two charge counters on Jitay.
All right. We'll just remember that.
Something you'll never like.
So you just chunked it?
Trying to think.
Sure.
You're eight. Okay, pass.
Okay. Another Grave Troll? Okay, I need the perfect cards. 2, 3, 4, we're not finding it. 5, 6. Nope, that's not happening. Even so, it's supposed to be Ichorid first, regardless. Okay.
Oh, I should have made a land drop. K.O.
Yeah, so Ichorid gets rid of eight Skullgari Thug, and then we just hope we get there. And by hope we get there, I mean I'm looking for another Cabal therapy, Ichorid, target myself. You know,
I could just swing thing. And buff this twice and win, right? Or just swing out and win.
Or just swing. Either way. Well, good job, man. I think I grossly misplayed that.
That's what I had in my head.
Yeah, there we go. Not bad, not bad. So, between games 2 and 3, I actually switched my sideboard. Game 2, I sided in Abrupt Decay, 2 up. Game 3, I sided in 2 Nature's Claims as well.
You still have the other
so,
green.
Let's see.
That spell bomb, dude.
That spell bomb.
Came in.
There are the decays. I'm a little ambivalent on Lotus Petal. Sometimes it seems great, sometimes not so much.
Lotus Petal's okay.
Yeah, it makes the deck a good bit faster, but if you don't. I mean, you can lose your mana pretty easily. So, triple Breakthrough and a Putrid Imp. It was 2 Breakthroughs and then Breakthrough Putrid Imp.
I don't really like Dredge. It's not like...
It's not my style of deck, but I still need to learn it. I still want to learn it.
It just seems too convoluted and everywhere. I can't do that. I like having everything together in one spot, and I like a bunch of stuff happening at one time.
For me, it's the consistency. I prefer a more consistent deck.
Yeah.
And while Dredge can be consistent once it starts going off, it doesn't run many lands while at the same time needing them.
I can only play you consistent can just brick. Decks. I can't play inconsistent, like, all or nothing decks.
Well, speaking of which, can we try another match then?
Sure.
All right.